When Steel Magnolias first opened off-Broadway in 1987, the critics were unanimous in their praise. The bittersweet human comedy centers around six very distinctly different women, individuals whose personalities, good, bad, and otherwise, are all based on a handful of local characters.
This is it. I have found it. I am in hell.
Good morning, Weezer.
Don't try to get on my good side, Truby. I no longer have one. Come here, Rip.
You're a little early, ain't you?
That is precisely why I'm here. I've got to talk to Malin about her husband. He is a boil on the butt of humanity.
I'm sorry, Weezer. This whole thing has gotten out of hand.
It's not your fault, Malin. You know, I used to think you were crazy for marrying that man. Then for a few years, I thought you were a glutton for punishment. Now I realize you must be on some mission from God.
It was the most pleasant, democratic, nurturing, tolerant, allowing, funny, sometimes raunchy, experience making a film I've ever had. There is just nothing like it.
Whenever any of us asked you what you wanted for us when we grew up, what did you say?
Shelby, I'm not in the mood to play games.
Just tell me what you said, Mama. What did you say?
The only thing I have ever said to you ever is that I want you to be happy.
Okay. The one thing that would make me happy is to have a baby.
Shelby's based on Bobby's sister, Susan. You know, Shelby and Susan, the one thing about them is that they weren't scared. You know, I mean, I live in absolute fear. Like, every day I'm scared of something. I'm going to have a wreck. I'm going to get a bill. I'm scared of running into this person, you know. I mean, just all these, like, little fears that invade your everyday life. And Shelby and Susan, they weren't scared to die. So if you're not scared to die, then what are you scared of?
I need your support. I would rather have 30 minutes of wonderful than a lifetime of nothing special.
If you had a child that had a disease that could take their life at any time, I imagine it would affect every relationship you ever had because you would be constantly thinking, is it going to be today? Have I done enough? Have I looked after her enough? Have I pushed her enough? Has she eaten enough? Is she doing too much? And then when she grows up and leaves the home and you've lost the actual contact with her daily to make her eat, make sure she's done all the things, you lose all power. And that's got to be really frightening.
You know, life is a combination of comedy and tragedy. Some of the funniest things I've ever heard have been said at funerals. I think what's so brilliant about what Robert wrote is that he has this wonderful ear and eye for the fact that everyone is a mixture of comedy and tragedy. They sure are in the South.